3 minutes before midnight on November 3rd, 2024, when many people were asleep, a major and deadly volcanic eruption began. This occurred on the Indonesian island of Flores, where, at the Laki-laki cone of the Lewotobi volcano, building gas and pressure finally broke through overlying rock, rapidly hurling thousands, if not tens of thousands, of up to car-sized lava bombs and volcanic blocks high into the air. Some of these projectiles were initially ejected at speeds of as high as 705 miles per hour or 1,135 kilometers per hour, being sent to heights as much as 4,000 meters above sea level. It would take a sizable amount of time for these boulders and bombs of lava to fall back to the ground, specifically as much as 49 seconds, by which time they landed as much as 11 kilometers or 6.84 miles from the Laki-Laki cone. This ejecta technically landed in all directions, but was almost exclusively being thrown towards the north, northwest, and west. Many of these sadly landed on structures, including homes, businesses, and schools. However, while stones were still falling, 500 degrees Celsius pyroclastic flows and surges were generated and raced down multiple sectors of the volcano, traveling as much as 4,000 meters away before coming to a halt. Although not known at the time, these pyroclastic flows and surges had quickly incinerated 11.34 square kilometers or 4.38 square miles of forested landscape, removing all green vegetation and only leaving behind the smoking remains of many trees' central trunks. The eruption then continued, raining down thick amounts of ash and lapilli, causing some roofs to collapse. Also, at some point, a loud blast by the eruption was easily heard 62 kilometers away in the city of Mamir. By the time the main phase of the eruption ended at 12:21 a.m. on November 4th, nearly 2,400 structures were damaged or destroyed, occurring alongside 9 deaths and 63 injuries. The only good news I have to report is that a person who is presumed dead after their house collapsed was found alive after being buried for 12 hours, meaning the death toll was revised downwards from 10 to 9. However, Laki-Laki is still erupting, albeit in a different and less intense manner. At the present, it is still producing occasional volcanic explosions, but is defined primarily by continuous weaker ash emissions, the curious formation of a lava lake, and intermittent Strombolian eruptive activity. There is a decent argument to be made, although this has not been proven, that the fresh patch of magma which triggered the recent eruption was basaltic and gas-rich, instead of the somewhat gas-depleted basaltic andesite magma, which had been erupting since December of last year. The previously plugged magma conduit is now wide open, likely far wider than it was beforehand, suggesting that another unusually powerful explosion is less likely to occur for the short-term future. There is also a bit of discussion as to why exactly there is now an opening of the summit crater to the northwest along a prior fissure, as the large eruption through this opening caused the majority of eruptive products to be directed to the northwest. We just aren't 100% sure why this opening formed. Possibilities include a minor debris avalanche, an incidental effect of the powerful volcanic eruption, the possibility that a lateral blast occurred, and the possibility that a small Paleian eruption occurred. I am still leaning towards the likelihood that this crater opening formed due to it representing a path of thinnest rock for expanding gases to erupt through via a volcanic eruption, but do not think material traveled far enough away or at a sufficient speed to actually signal that a lateral eruption occurred. The trees weren't all blown down outwards from the eruption site like this. Regardless of its cause, there is now a more immediate effect that this opening will serve. Not only are future eruptive products more likely to be directed again to the northwest, but the pooling lava pond could overflow in that direction, forming an advancing, albeit slow-moving, basaltic lava flow. Scientists are still monitoring the situation to analyze what might happen next.